Blackstone Audio presents Inside Delta Force, the story of America's elite counterterrorist unit, by Eric L. Haney. Introduction. I am a nomad, son of an ancient line of nomads. The larger part of my family line is made up of the Scots-Irish, a people descended from that peculiar mixture of the Celts of the northern British Isles and the invading Danes and Norsemen. The result was a landless, illiterate, anarchic, and warlike people who were always difficult, if not downright impossible, to govern. They were a race the British Crown rightfully viewed as dangerous rebels, and consequently exiled to the New World by the tens of thousands. On arrival in the American colonies, these people fled as far as possible from government control, many of them crossing the Blue Ridge Mountains and migrating from there throughout what eventually became the highlands of the southern United States. They were the original backwoodsmen of American history. In their new home, these renegade peoples tended to travel together in interrelated clans that also married and bred quite readily with the Cherokee and Creek Indians of the region. Both sides of my family were landless sharecroppers and mountain people as far back as I can determine. There is no written record of ancestry, for my parents were the first of our people to read and write, and to own a little property. Inherited wealth may be something easily squandered, but inherited poverty is a legacy almost impossible to lose. What did I receive from this lineage? Things I consider to be very valuable. A good raw intellect and a good tough body. A sense of independence and a realization that wherever I am is my home. A sense of humor. A sense of personal honor that results in a touchiness common to our people. We are easily offended and prone to violence when offended. When the only thing you own is your sense of honor, you tend to protect it at all costs. I inherited a sense of wanderlust and a curiosity about the world. I inherited a warlike attitude. We have always been good soldierly material if properly disciplined and broken in. I inherited a sense of spirituality rather than religion, which has served me well, especially in trying times. I am self-confident and resilient. My psyche is self-cleansing. I love life. I grew up in the mountains of North Georgia during the 50s and 60s. It was then part of the Third World, and some say it still is. Electricity came to our home when I was a young boy. Indoor plumbing followed some years later. Though I have some fair native intelligence, I never received any direction in school and was often an indifferent student, but I loved to read and would consume all my textbooks at the start of the year and then coast after that. I preferred roaming the mountains, hunting, fishing, and exploring. I would become the first of my family to graduate high school, and for us that was considered a pretty good achievement, as our expectations weren't very high. It isn't that my parents were against education, it's that neither of them had gone further than elementary school, and they just didn't have the ability or the understanding to help. Though we may not have been scholars, we did know how to go into the military. I had grown up listening to the war stories and tales of my family and friends, and I was determined to join up just as soon as I was able. I enlisted in the Army in the spring of 1970, while still in high school, with a reporting date immediately after graduation. I fell in love with the Army as soon as I met her. I became a professional soldier, and that is what I will be until I die. The military is a profession that brands itself on the soul and causes you forever after to view the world and all human endeavor through a unique set of mental filters. The more profound and intense the experience, the hotter the brand, and the deeper it is plunged into you. I was seared to the core of my being. For 20 years, I served America in the most demanding and dangerous units in the United States Army, as a combat infantryman, as a ranger, and ultimately as a founding member and 8-year veteran of the Army's super-secret counterterrorist arm, Delta Force. Close, brutal combat puts a callous layer on each individual who undergoes the experience. With some men, their souls become trapped inside those accrued layers, and they stay tightly bound up within themselves, unable or unwilling to reach out.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.